الحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله.
Being grateful to Allah, my brothers and sisters, another feeling that has to come through your mind and your heart while you're praying is what Allah gave you, what Allah deserves, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Forget about His feet, forget about His love. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us so much ni'am, so much gift, subhanahu wa ta'ala, He gave us. Don't you feel gratitude? Don't you feel ashamed? Don't you feel shy? Allah gave me everything I have. Allah gave me everything I'm enjoying. And I can't prostrate my forehead before Him and thank Him properly. I can't give Him some time of my day and say thank you Allah for what you're giving me. This is why Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was not praying like us. He was not praying thinking, I have to pray, I have to offload my salah. He was praying tahajjud at night. Aisha, his wife radiallahu anha, narrates. She goes, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to pray at night so long until his feet would crack and sweat. His skin would crack, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from long standing in salat. فَقُلْتُ لَهُ لِمَا تَصْنَعُ هَذَا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَقَدْ غَفَرَ اللَّهُ لَكَ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِكَ وَمَا تَأَخَّرَ. Why are you doing so much, Ramadan Allah, when Allah has forgiven your sins? You know, she was thinking like, subhanAllah, she's higher than all of us, of course. But the same thought comes. Imagine if I say to you, brother, you're going for Dawsul A'la, don't worry about it, what will happen? We'll end up clapping every day, no one will start praying. But Muhammad, although he knew, khalas, that's it. Salah, you know, Jannah is guaranteed, the highest ranks. Never prepared for hellfire touches on us. He knows he's in the highest ranks. But yet, he used to pray so long. So Aisha was confused. Why are you doing so much stress? So he says, look at the hadith. قَالَ أَفَلَا أُحِبُّ أَنْ أَكُونَ عَبَدًا شَكُورًا. Shouldn't I wish, shouldn't I want to be a thankful slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? I want to thank Allah. I feel this gratitude. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was shy from his heart. He had the shyness in his heart. Allah made me a prophet. Allah gave me everything. Allah gave me victory. Allah gave me strength. Allah gave me the Quran. Allah gave me the Fatiha like our Shaykh Sayyidina Fatiha. Allah gave me all this. I'm not going to stand the salah. I'm not going to praise Allah. I'm not going to thank Him. Forget about you know, the rewards and the ranks. He was shy. Where is this shyness in our hearts now? Do we feel shy from Allah? Yeah, we feel shy. Allah gave me everything. Allah gave me my job, my wife, my kids, my husband. Allah gave me the money I have, the house I own, the car I'm driving, the health. Everything Allah gave me. Don't I want to praise Allah and thank Him? Don't I give Him attention for 5 minutes? Wallahi, it's a shame. These feelings, don't wallahi, if before the salah you spend 5 times thinking of these feelings and meanings, your salah will be on different levels completely. You will reach different levels completely in your salah. Just think of these meanings. Gratitude, belittle yourself before Allah. Who am I? Who am I standing before Allah? You know, the feeling comes, there's like a discussion happening. You will actually feel that inshaAllah my salah was accepted and it will cause the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those who are believed. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and enjoin them.